Paul Virilio, the architect philosopher, argues that the most important product of contemporary societies is speed. It's a shocking thought, but I think it is becoming more and more true, true that it is the acceleration of time that, contemporary life is causing. I'm myself guilty of speed in terms of my, travels. I'm on my 105th trip around the world now, and I know that it's totally immoral. But somehow I have been thrown to this orbit as a young man, and I will step out of the orbit fairly soon. But I think to speed there are two aspects. External speed, which you, for instance, experience in cities, and then an internal speed or slowness of the mind. I grew up during the war years at my farmer grandfather's very humble farmhouse in central Finland. And from those childhood years, I have derived a understanding and appreciation of both slowness and silence. And I would probably be out of my mind going places so much as I have done without this solid ground in my childhood of silence and slowness. Slowness is something that that is not only essential for our, you know, balance of the mind, but also for our creative capacity. I feel very sorry about the architectural profession, which is nowadays caught by this speed of production, and as a consequence, architecture is turning into a you know, production rather than creation. And unfortunately, the technical media and computers have speeded up the process tremendously. So I myself try to slow down and teach my students the importance of slowness and silence. And I write about these things. I have written several essays on both slowness and silence. Silence is also an equally important thing which has disappeared from normal life. Here, when coming to this town, I was really impressed by the presence of sounds, because the constant noise of traffic is away. You hear people talking all the time. This is a fact that historians can prove, that our world was a oral or acoustic world until about the late 17th century, when it became began to turn into a visual world. And as Walter J. Ong argues in his very fine book, Literacy and Orality, the invention that began this process was printing, which in his view turned the world into a cold, insistent world of facts, of vision. And I have noticed recently, or during the past years, that there is a growing interest in architecture schools and art schools of on the role of the other senses, which somehow reveals a dissatisfaction and understanding that we have entered a problematic stage in our relation with the world. sensory relation.